Mordechai Museum from Holocaust to Revival. The museum was designed on a conceptual design by Abba Kovner, who was opened in 1968. It was by architects Ari Sharon and his son Eldar. This is in the Yad Mordechai in pre-life Warsaw. Thank you. life in Warsaw under the Nazi decrees. It's from Krakow, a Nazi decree. The reconstruction of the train where so many were deported to the various camps, including Treblinka. Warsaw Ghetto. The Warsaw Ghetto, we now entering the Warsaw Ghetto there. Memorial Wall of the Uprising, Jewish Armed Resistance to the Ghettos. Before we go, this is the Ramosa. And here's an iconic picture of loaded onto the cattle trucks. And this is a model of Warsaw. Miller 18. The bunch at Miller 18.
That's everyone on this land in 14 in total. Come, Catherine.
That's it.
I am not leaving without them.
You are putting us all at risk.
I am not asking you, I am telling you.
Sylvia, get on the truck. Sylvia, get on the truck.
This is Mordechai and Lebich with friends in Warsaw. Here we see the Jewish fighters captured in the uprising of, in the Warsaw in 1943, the burning ghetto in 1943, and here's a very iconic picture, very sad, a Jewish fighter jumping from a burning building in 1943. And the Warsaw Ghetto uprising was from April the 19th of 1943 to May the 16th. And it took the Germans longer to capture the Warsaw Ghetto than to destroy the whole of Poland.
Yet they have persevered, no, more than persevered. They have conquered these conditions and fought on way to the whole world.
Mordechai Anilevich. heard it's from the Warsaw Ghetto. Shalom Yitzhak. There's but one way to express my feelings of those of my comrades that happened beyond our most daring dreams. The Germans fled the ghetto twice. One of our companies held on 40 minutes, another held on over 6 hours. The grenade buried in the brush markets exploded. We only had one casualty, Yechiel. He has fallen as a hero near the machine gun. The overall situation at all the factories within the outside of the ghetto have closed, but a few workshops. I have no information about the situation in Schlitz. Communication was disconnected. The brush markets, workshops, and fire. The past few days, I have no contact with other companies. Many fires throughout the ghetto. He says, hospitals will burn, entire blocks are on fire. This is from Mordechai in the 23rd of the 4th, 1943. I cannot describe to you what conditions Jews live here. Only some chosen ones will survive. The rest will perish. Sooner or later, the fate is sealed. In all bunkers where our comrades are hiding, it is impossible to light a candle at night because there is no air. Only one man is missing among the ghetto companies, Yechiel. This is a victory too. I don't know if I will write you again. I imagine questions arising, but the time, please be satisfied with this. Peace be with you, my dear friend. May we see each other again. Most importantly, my life aspirations fulfilled. I was blessed to see Jewish self-defense, its greatness and glory in the Warsaw Ghetto. And here are survivors in Italy in 1945. And there were other ghettos in the Vilna ghetto, the surrounding forest, the Jewish underground were determined to turn the deep forest terrain into a gathering point and battleground for the survivors. And the annihilated ghetto and the death camp deportations. Upon reaching the forest, Jewish men and women formed partisan units, became part of the immense partisan force operating behind enemy lines. The sabotage and harassment activity paved the way for advancing the victorious Allied army. And here's Jewish partisan dynamiting railway tracks. In a train blown up by Jewish partisans. So those who survived, the remnants, tried to come to, it was Mandate Palestine, under the British control, and there was the exodus from Europe towards the shores of the Jewish homeland. And many were deported to Cyprus. The British, they intercepted the ships and they deported many to Atlit, and then before they got to Atlit, they were deported to Cyprus. This was the illegal immigration. It was the establishment of settlements in the Negev in the night of Yom Kippur in 1946. Water pipeline from 940 is shown on the map. Oh, this is original. These are the different Yishuvim, Yishma HaNegev, Orim, Kedma, Kvadarom, Shaval, Tavim, Nirim, Gal-On, Azerib, Tukuma, Ba'eri, first water pipelines in the Negev, in 1946, 1947 to 1948, this was the partition plan. This is a mountain gun from France, model from 1906. It was produced in 1917. Three such guns were brought to the area on the June 2nd, 1948 to help stop the Egyptian invasion. On July 15th, these two guns were important in pushing Egyptian forces out of the kibbutz Beit Yitzhak, some 4 kilometers east of Gaza. And here's an aerial photo of Yad Mordechai from 1968. And this is the map of the Egyptian army movements and attacks in 1948. Mordechai Anilevich was a member of Hashomer Hatzair youth movement in Warsaw, Poland. In April 1943, was the commander of the uprising of the ghetto kibbutz. Yad Mordechai is named after him. His last wish is fulfilled. The independent Jewish resistance has come through. I am happy to be among the first Jewish fighters in the ghetto. From his last letter of the 23rd of the 4th, 1943. See the water towers from 1945, and how it is in 1949, how it was bombed. Shell 2-pounder. These are the shells. Original artifacts from Yad Mordechai. The model of a Palmach fighter. And these were kibbutz fighters. These are original mortar bombs and the rifles, Stern gun. The Browning machine guns was used by the kibbutz fighters against Egyptian army attack from May the 19th to 23rd, 1948. It had been captured earlier outside the kibbutz. On May 1948, four Arabs in a jeep stopped on the main road and opened fire on the kibbutz. A Palmach armed truck surprised them, killed the Arabs and took the Browning machine guns that were on the jeep. The gun was hidden in the kibbutz secured from the British patrols. The next day, a Palmach member came to teach the kibbutz members how to operate the gun. The machine gun had a major role in repulsing the Egyptian infantry attack on the kibbutz. This is the model of the kibbutz in 1948. Front page of Al-Akhram, 28th of May 1948. The entire edition was dedicated to the visit of Egyptian King Farouk at the kibbutz in Mordechai, which had been conquered by the Egyptians. In one photograph, the damaged water tower of the kibbutz is shown with the Egyptian flag on top. Another shows the destroyed security building and King Farouk listening to explanation by officers of his army. This is a plaster model of Mordechai Anilevich. From the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising. This is the water tower that stood, first built in 1945. In the juxtaposition of Mordechai and the water tower is very symbolic.